Yeah! All right, now there's a song we wrote about 5 minutes ago. It's called Photograph.
Aw, crap, I'm at the wrong concert. Aw, crap, I'm in the wrong country. It's one thing to listen to an artist you really like, but to see them perform your favorite songs right in front of you, or far away from you because your broke ass can't afford closer seats, is such a mind-blowing experience. But here's the thing, while they may be a good time, they can also be a lot of work. Now I know a thing or two about music, if it's music theory, or being in a band, or just having so much knowledge on a specific artist, music is my life. I have been to many concerts, and growing up a rebellious punk rocker, a lot of them were rock shows, though as I got older, I started going to shows with different genres. The last show I went to was Logic, and the first concert I ever went to was Linkin Park. RIP Chester. And if you were to compare the two, technically they're both considered hip-hop when you count Mike Shinoda's rapping, but I learned the crowds at hip-hop, house, or electronic shows are hella different compared to the ones at a punk, emo, or metal show. One of my favorite concerts was Blink-182, and yes, I like them with Matt. I know some people prefer Tom because it's that classic lineup, even though I prefer Mark and Travis more. I think both Tom and Matt have their own unique style. I liked them before, and I like them now. And I still question myself, why did Blink-182 go on tour with Lil Wayne? I mean, need I remind you that this happened? Venereal disease, like a menstrual bleed through the pencil and ink on the sheet of the tablet in my mind, cause I don't write shit cause I ain't got time, cause my second limit hours go to the almighty dollar and the almighty power of the chapasin. That's about the time she walked away from me. What? Next you'll have Camila Cabello do a song with Limp Bizkit. I saw Blink-182 three times, but the first time I saw them was also the first time I went to a festival. Which is a good way to save money, cause you're paying to see many dope artists, instead of paying a lot of money to see one band you really like, and then another band open for them that no one even cares about. It is also muy importante that you watch how much you pay at a concert. Since, you know, you gotta pay all those hidden fees, like the service fee, the delivery fee, the fee. Yeah. Here's what I think about your little fees.
Armin wins. Flawless victory.
Toasty!
This festival had Blink and a few other bands that you've probably never heard of because you're 10. Bonus points to those who know any of these bands. So I was driving up to see this concert with my boy Ross and this other guy who I don't really talk to anymore, so we'll just call him Face. So me, Ross, and Face were in the car jamming to their music. By the way, I don't know if this is true, but I heard that it's bad luck if you listen to an artist right before you're about to see them live. I don't know, but I was like, I don't care. At least we knew their songs, because there'd be people who go to concerts and they only know like their two biggest hits. So while I'd be there rocking out, acting stupid, getting drunk with my best friends, there'll be another guy next to me just like, I'm like, bruh, stop. You're embarrassing yourself. While we were at the festival, there would be a few times where Travis Barker would walk by, and he's just trying to enjoy his time like the rest of us. He was with his kids, and I would literally see people following him everywhere he went. It was so awkward. His daughter looked traumatized. It's cool when you see a celebrity you look up to, but you also gotta remember, they're just people. So, when you got a bunch of people all up in your business like this, that's just not cool. So by the time Blink-182 was about to come on, the guys and I ended up making friends with some other people. And that's another cool thing about going to concerts, is making friends with your own kind. Punks making friends with other punks, and we all shoved our way through everyone so we could get to the very front. The only thing that sucked was there were a lot of big, sweaty, less attractive guys, and this was an all-floor show. So there were no seats, no sections, just one big floor of people, and already these guys were squishing us and suffocating the hell out of me. The band didn't even come on yet. With all my experience with going to concerts, I already expected a lot of pushing and shoving and big people blocking my view because I'm so damn short, but not when the music hasn't even started yet. But the second the band came out everyone went nuts. And I went straight for the mosh pit, because I love moshing and I love crowd surfing, and I'm lucky I'm not like those big ugly guys, because I'm easier to carry when it comes to crowd surfing. But this show was way more intense than I thought it was going to be. After the first song, I already lost the guys I was with, I lost the new friends I made, and I was all by myself. I couldn't handle the intensity anymore. It's like Timmy Turner was at the concert and just magically made all my friends disappear with the help of his
fingerprints!
Cause after all, I came here to have fun, and I crowd surfed my way out of the front row, so for the rest of the show, I was still close enough, but I was on the side. At least I could breathe while I was having fun. Unlike those who have their phones out literally during the entire show, I was singing along to every one of their songs. I was living in the moment. And as soon as they ended their show with their last song, Family Reunion, here's a quick look at the lyrics, by the way. The concert sadly came to an end. I lost my voice, my ears were ringing like the morning bell, I had bruises from all those guys that trampled me in the mosh pit, and I was drenched in my own sweat. I can't wait to go back. Luckily, I was able to find Ross and Face right out of the blue, along with only one of those other friends that we made before the show started. The others, I have no idea what happened to them. Nice knowing you, I guess. The bad news was this poor girl lost her phone, her keys, her wallet, her identity. That one side of me that can be a tool was like, yeah, sucks girl, but I don't know you that well. And I didn't want to be mean, so I said I told her I would help her find her stuff. I guess you can say I But really, I did feel bad. I believe that everything happens for a reason. So in a way, it was a good thing that we stayed a little longer, because getting out of the parking lot after a concert sucks monkey nuts. And we were able to avoid all that. After like an hour or two, boom, the girl was able to find all her stuff. Then we all got each other's numbers. We followed each other on the gram. That's when I thought, all right, let's hit the road. Until we just so happened to pass by a Mr. Travis Barker. I think he was just taking a few quick pictures with the fans, so he was chill enough to take some with us as well. See? Everything happens for a reason. Even though I didn't get to meet Mark or Matt, I did actually get to meet Tom DeLonge one time, very briefly. Fast forward like 1 year, I was in line for the premiere of Star Wars The Last Jedi, and I see this tall dude who looks like that one dude that used to be in that band I really like. Couldn't tell if it was him though, so my friend Pierce was like, "Hey Arm & Hammer, you should just yell his name and see if he looks at you." And I did just that. I'd be like, "Tom!" He didn't look. So I'd do it again. "Tom DeLonge!" He still didn't look. So as we got closer to the front, I see him and I just politely say, "Hey, I like your music." And he said to me, "Oh, thanks." From the tone of that robot-sounding voice, it was pretty obvious he was Tom. So I guess that means I met 2/3 of Blink-182. If that counts, I don't know. I'm just gonna say it does. And that's my story about going to concerts and meeting Blink-182. The end.